Today we will study about vectorization. So in case you don't remember, let's see the NLTK pipeline diagram once again. So these are the main stages of NLTK pipeline while processing a text data. So we are done reading with the raw text data, where we read the raw text using pandas read CSV function into a data frame. And then we tokenized it, and we also did data cleaning where we removed the punctuations. And after tokenization, we removed the stop words from them, and then we used lemmatization and stemming on those tokenized words. So now after we have a clean list of tokens or words, we are ready for this stage, which is vectorization. So here we have the list of words, word 1, word 2, and so on. But any algorithm, Python, it will not understand these characters, but it needs some numbers in order to work on train on those. So vectorization is just the process of taking this list of tokens, clean words, and then converting it into some numerical representation or feature vectors. So we see that how we can represent each of these words as some feature vector. So once again, vectorization is the process of encoding text as integers to create feature vectors. And if you don't know what are feature vectors, then these are just vector of numerical features that represent an object. For example, we may have a word, let's say W1, or let's say it's cat. And we know that there are only three letters or three words in a dictionary, or five words, let's say, and cat comes at fourth position, then one of the possible representation would be that fourth position is 1, others are 0. So this is just one of the ways of representing this word cat. If a dictionary has five words and the position of cat is fourth, then we can keep fourth as 1, rest as 0. So this is a feature vector. Now let's see some more example. So let's say our dictionary has 100 words, and we have a list of documents. By documents we mean messages. So in our SMS spam collection database, we have, so this every row corresponds to one document. So each message will have some words. So let's say we read all those, the complete data set, and we figured out that there are 100 unique words. Then to represent the first message, we will see how many times W1 has occurred in this message, let's say 0. How many times W2 has occurred in this first message, let's say 2. How many times W3 has occurred, let's say 0, and so on. And this one has occurred 1 times, and its level is ham or spam. And here we have just 2 levels, so we can denote them by 0 or 1. Let's say 0 is ham and 1 is spam. So let's say it's level 0. Similarly, for second message, we have 0, 3, 1, and 1. And its level is also 0. And for third, it's 4, 0, 3, 0, and it's a spam. So this is just one way of representing it. And this technique we call as count vectorization, because here we are keeping the cell values are actually representing the count of that word in a particular message. So this is just one of the ways of vectorization. There are other methods also. We will see them in later videos. And this matrix we call document matrix or document term matrix. So now you understand the concept of vectorization. So we can represent this first message by this vector of 100 dimension. So this is a 100 dimension vector, and this is 0, 2, 0, ... 1. Similarly for second sentence, and similarly for third, and so on. So the other types of vectorization are count vectorization, we already saw. Then we have n-grams, and then we have TF-IDF, which stands for term frequency inverse document frequency. So we will see all of these in further videos, and in the next video we will see how to use count vectorization that is included in NLTK package. So see you in the next video. Thank you.